Hi there guys, it's Qwerty Afro here bringing you another video, and we're gonna do the next mission of European Ship Simulator. What they're trying to do, they're releasing each week a different mission. So for each mission, I'm just gonna basically do a video for you guys of each of the missions that they release eventually till the kind of release of the game, or I don't even know actually how long they're actually gonna be doing this game in early access, but so far I'm liking it. We're gonna be doing the second mission, which is the ferry mission. It's just here to dock here in Dover, and then we're going to sail over to Calais, and then we're going to berth there in Calais and drop off the passengers. So it's a nice little mission to see how the actual ferry kind of works. They've added some more missions and stuff like that, which I need to get over. I've been kind of bad not keeping up with the missions, but I'm going to do this one for you. I think there's right now about 6 missions. They've also added another port. Currently there was only just Dover and Calais in the game, but they've added another port as well. But we'll eventually get to all of the kind of missions and stuff, and I'll just keep you guys updated with this game, because I really am enjoying it, and I think it's going to, with the right development, I think it's going to be a pretty good game. And I have mentioned that in the first video, that I was saying that this game really has a lot of potential, and you guys seem to like it as well. So let's continue. Let's slowly just get this ship to start moving. We obviously have to go there. You can actually see where the waypoint is. We have to go, if you can see it over there, we have to go into that berthing area, and we'll just, you know, get the ship tied up, get the passengers on, and then we'll head over to Dover. Also, the shoutouts for this video go to Trainspotter Blake and F.k.w. That's again Trainspotter Blake and F.k.w. Their links and stuff will be down below. Please show them some love. And those were the shoutouts for this video. So I'm sorry guys, there hasn't been a lot of videos, just been busy. I've gotten back from Leicester now. I'm in London. Still things a little bit unsorted here. Had a lot of friends that I had to catch up with, etc., family, etc. as well, so it's just been, in a way, hectic coming up to the holiday seasons. But I'm definitely now going to get into the gist of getting those nice videos out, and obviously towards Christmas we're going to get some Christmassy stuff, you know, it'd be really cool. Also, obviously, because the Christmas DLC for the Train Sim came out, so I have to do a video of that. And if you guys watch the streams, I'll be giving out games and stuff on the streams, for, like, you know, Christmas kind of spirit. I've got a few copies of that Christmas DLC for Train Sim, so I'll be giving that out on, like, some of the streams I do. So be sure to tune in to the streams when I do streams and that, etc. But anyway, we're doing European Ship Simulator right now. It's going very quietly, actually, in development. I'm not seeing nothing too major. All they're doing, as I said, is they're releasing each week some DLC. Well, not the DLC, they're just updating the game each week. They are adding either a new ship. I think we've got another ship, which is the fishing boat. I think that's the fishing boat over there, as you can see there with the... can zoom out enough, which I actually don't think we can, but that's the fishing boat that's just come out, and it's playable in a mission, which we'll get into a video in the future of it. But yeah, they've released that. They've released a new port, Rostock or something like that it's called, I think. So that's pretty cool. But we'll get to all of that. I'll definitely do all these kind of missions and stuff of the video, because I'm really interested in this video, and into this game, and I really want to see it do well in development, because I was an avid Ship Simulator Extremes player, and I really did enjoy playing it. But I must say, it kind of got boring after a while. I played a lot of 2008, Ship Simulator 2008, and then I basically kind of got bored of that. And then when Extremes came out, I was like so excited, and I really was like, yes, this could be good. And to be honest, it wasn't anything different to 2008. They sharpened up the graphics a bit, made the water a bit more dynamic, I guess, if you want to put it like that. They made it a bit more dynamic, and that's pretty much it all they did with that game. And they released some DLC, and I thought their DLC prices and structure was really bad. So that kind of got boring for me, and then there hasn't really been anything since then that has really caught my eye to actually be a decent ship sim kind of game or title. And then this comes along, European Ship Simulator, and it's actually looking good. I'm really happy. As I said, I pointed out a few things that I didn't like in the first video, and that's still there. Obviously, it's still in development. It's still heavily being designed today still. But for what it is right now, I'm really enjoying it. It's really fun, really smooth, as I said. People have had some problems with it crashing or whatever, but they're really quick to kind of iron out. They're really quick to iron out things that, like, the gamers and stuff that are playing it are having problems with. So they're a very good, like, team that responds good to the people that are actually playing it, and it's great. It's a great little thing. I always keep up with the forums and read the forums of what's happening. I don't really post anything myself. I'm a person that just likes to watch and see how is it developed. If I need to suggest anything, I would suggest anything, but for now I just like playing it and kind of observing where it's going, and I'm happy with it. And you guys seem to really like the first video. You guys really seem to be digging this game really, really well. That's good to know. Wait, so I'm now. Okay, good. I'm turning. Okay. I've seen people do this mission where they just literally go straight in, but I like to just reverse in a bit. I think reversing is nicer, and then once you reverse, you can just go straight out once you pick up the passengers. That's what I tend to do, and that's what most ships tend to do. And it's the thing with ships, like say with ferries, it depends what way the cars have come in or which way the cars are going to go in. Because it normally with ferry ships, you normally have the front that can open and you have the back here that can open. But I'm just assuming that that the passengers that I'm picking up here will just go in from the back, and then they'll just, you know, come out from the front in Calais. So in Calais, we won't go in like this. We'll just go in straight. So it kind of makes it a little easier for us when we get to Calais instead of us maneuvering. And I think the port at Calais is a bit more difficult to maneuver through. As I'd already tried this scenario in on stream, so I kind of know what I was dealing with and what not to do. So I'm just gonna do it like this. And then at Calais, it'll make it a little easier. Also, another thing with this game is that when you touch something, like say if you touch the side or something, it literally goes into automatic. It goes into automatic sync mode. So if you, in a way, fuck up a bit, you just automatically sync. So it's interesting. I'll say that. Right. I think I'm okay. Good. Yes. Right. Stop and position your ship. Right. I think we've stopped. Okay. Now we just go. I kind of slammed into the back, but I think that's all right. I think it's if you go into the side that's a bit annoying. Let me just turn off this thrust, which can be a little annoying. Let me just turn it off. They need to work on getting the controls to center at zero a bit, because it's hard to center at zero without being really, really precise. Which that's what I find can be a little bit annoying. The walking around is pretty cool, I guess. I hope they make things a bit more explorable, because right now it kind of feels that we only have the bridge or like the place where we are driving the ship. That's the only kind of place it kind of feels like we have to explore. So I hope, like say with a ship this big, I hope it'll be, you know, I hope we'll be able to, you know, go around, walk around, go inside. I hope the ships have decent interiors, which would be really cool. I should start turning the ship a bit. Right now you can see like there's nothing really in the inside. I've just put pictures in as the placeholder for like the kind of interior of the ship, because we don't know what's actually going to be in the inside of the ship. Like, will we be able to open, like, say, on the ferries, will we be able to open these kind of, like, doors where the cars and stuff would go drive in? Can we actually walk through that? That would be really cool if we could. And I hope that's something they will be, you know, looking to do, in a way. So let's just, you know, only, like, the detail is good. I like the detail, as I said when I was playing through actually this scenario on the stream. I was really happy with the kind of detail that's so far being shown through the ship. It's really good. And it's pretty stable, like, it's good. The dynamics of the ship moving are alright. As I said in the first video, the water is good by itself, but the interaction between the ship and the water is still a little iffy. There's nothing really, except for like these kind of little splashes and stuff, there's nothing really showing, nothing's really showing us that the ship is actually making the water, you know, move or anything like that. That's something I hope that will get fixed. But so far, for what it is, it's actually pretty good. And I'm really happy with it. I like it, it's great. Sounds are a little bit, like right now I can only hear the sound here and not like at the front. It'd be cool if I can hear the sound anyway. This is the Port Dover, arrive at Cali, port entry by 6:30, have a nice trip. Okay, we shall. Timing's pretty sensitive actually. We can do a fast, but once we get a fast, track, we'll just skip to Cali, because we can do the full journey if we wanted to, but that's going to be a little too long, if you know what I mean. And that ship is pretty close to us, isn't it? You see what I mean right now? You can see the waves and stuff that the sea is doing itself. This is the sea dynamically, you know, with the waves and stuff. But you don't actually get anything from the actual ship that actually makes these waves or anything. That's the thing I'm a little annoyed about. Because it feels like I'm just driving a ship on, like, you know, the ship feels static. The water feels really dynamic. Let me do a little horn salute to the ship over there. There we go. I like that. It's very graceful, I like it. I like bigger ships, like ferry ships and stuff like that. I always wanted to actually be a sea captain in a way. I wanted to, you know, drive ships. And I've been on, like, many ships when I go on holiday. And it's just, I really, like, as I said, and I've said this, like, when I was talking about ship simulators, I was more interested in ships than, like, say, trains or whatever. I got into ship sims before train sims. And I was, in a way, more interested in ships from an early age. Like, ships and trains kind of stayed in my head from when I was young. So I'm really excited about anything to do with ships and then anything to do with trains, basically, because those are, like, my two kind of favorite kind of, you know, transport kind of types. And so I'm really happy that there's actually a simulator now that's actually going to cater for my ship sim needs, if you know what I mean. But yeah, I'm really, really happy, and so far so good. Because I think also the inspiration is also because my uncle is actually a first officer on he works with Royal Caribbean, and he's a first officer on like Royal Caribbean ships. He's like been the first officer on the Freedom of the Seas. And I think now he's on the Independence of the Seas, I think. You can skip the trip to destination by clicking the jump button. We'll do that in a bit. We'll get up to speed. We'll get up to see how fast this ship can actually go. And then we'll jump to the thing so we just, you know, we can save time. Because we could just sit here and actually do the whole trip. But obviously that's going to take quite some time. And maybe, who knows, maybe in some future videos when this actually game comes out, maybe we'll do those kind of really, really long, those really long hauls. But right now, there's not a lot of AI and stuff, so it's not going to be that entertaining to actually watch to sit out here through like an hour traveling across the channel. But definitely, hopefully in the future, it'll be a bit more like dynamic, maybe even when multiplayer comes around for this game, which they've heard they saying that they would like to implement something like that in the future, obviously not now while they're just building the game up from scratch, but it would be something cool to do in the future. But yeah, right now we're doing 20 knots. So see, the thing also, it doesn't really feel like we're going fast, Because, as I said, the water's moving one way, we're moving one way. Like, say now the water's moving with us, which is very, you can get that. The water's moving with us, some of it's cutting through the ship, but the ship, it doesn't look very, the ship just looks like it's standing still and the water's just moving through it and we're getting some little splashes from the front and the back. Obviously, like, this is something that Ship Simulator Extremes or whatever did better. Like, you had, like, some, you know, waves and stuff like that. Hopefully this will be addressed in the future, but that's not something I want to worry about right now because, obviously, they're just, you know, for now, this is great. I love the water. That's one of the things I just love. I love looking at it. It's just great. It's absolutely just, you know, it's great. Anyway, let's skip over to Calais. So, right now, you're in time, Captain. We are in time indeed. Now, this is where things get a little real. Once we are, you know, going through into the port, we should be slowing down, but I'm just going to go a little full steam ahead, be a little bit of a naughty captain and just, you know, but I'm not going to be as, like, bad as that captain that sunk the Concordia. Like, no way. That guy just completely was just showing off. Or whatever, like he was driving his ship in an area which was not suitable for ships like that big, and he took that risk just to show off, like, his ship to, like, you know, like the island that they were passing, and yeah, that ended up really badly. But you know, some people just can't take their job seriously in a way, and then he kind of, like, you know, he ran for his life when the ship was sinking and didn't even care. Like, but the captain shouldn't be the first one off. He should be the last one off. And is this ship okay? This ship's cool. Wow, look at that, the waves are destroying that ship. Right, we should start turning, of course. Blow down the engines a bit so we just get to a nice speed. We don't want to go too fast. Also, the sun is really nice and the reflection on the water is just perfect. It's great. It's great. I just love it. It's so great. Like, I like these kind of games. Like, some simulators are just so peaceful. And I think, like, a ship sim is just one of the most peaceful simulators you can actually do because it's so relaxing. Like, you have the water. And I think, obviously, the water has to be something that is done really well in a game like this because, like, in real life, when you look at water, and, like, say you're looking at a nice sunset when you're coming into a harbour, it's so nice and calming to just look at the water, how it reacts, or whatever, and that's what I like about, you know, ships, like, the whole kind of thing with the interaction with water, that's the whole thing with ships, in real life, with ships. The water is just the most important thing, in a way. A little bit of a Christmas cold. It's not bad. It's not affecting me too much. I haven't had really any sort of cold. I've had little tiny runny noses or whatever, but literally so many people I know have just been struggling with, like, really bad colds, and I haven't had any of that yet, which hopefully I won't get anything, like, after Christmas, like, when I have, like, 3 exams in January to do, so I really hope that nothing comes by January because I'd be really, really upset. Let's just get these ones pushing a little bit this way so we can just, you know, head in a way. We'll just lower the speed now completely because we're gonna have to be mooring this up now. Alright. And I'm just gonna go head first in. Go 0 degrees. We need to push the back over. Oh, that's not the back, this is the back. Oh crap, I got the wrong controls. Oh wait, maybe that's the front. Okay. Okay, actually, this is not too bad. This is not too bad. Right. Zero. Ooh. Ooh, we're just gonna get a little bump. Hopefully, that should help us. Just go. I don't know which one's the front. I don't know which thruster's the front. That's one thing I kind of keep getting confused. So that's going the negative way. Okay. Let's see. Is this one the front? How's this moving? I need to see how it reacts. Okay, so that's the back. Okay, good. So that's the back. We're moving this in now a little bit. We're going to get the front one to move in as well a bit. You see how what I'm trying to do now? I'm trying to move the ship in this way. And that's what thrusters are good for when maneuvering ships. You're going to try and just get the ship to kind of maneuver in by itself. I'll just lower the back one a bit because I think we're good with that. And then we'll get the front. And then once we... There we go. This is Port Calais. Please stop your ship and onboard passengers. Okay, so we just have to lower that. Lower the RPM a bit. We'll just get it to zero, hopefully, if I can. This is one thing, as I said, it's a bit annoying not getting it to zero. Well, two, I think, is fine. That's good. Okay, well done. That's nice. Mission successful. Nice job, Captain. So, I hope you liked that mission. I think that was pretty cool. There are other missions, as I said. There is, from Calais to Dover, bulk carrier, the fishing in Dover, another passenger ferry, maneuvers in Calais, and a busy day at the dock, Rostock. So, we have four more missions to go through. Obviously, missions are going to keep getting added. So, I really like this kind of thing where I can just do a video of each mission and just show you how this game just builds up with the addition of more content to it. But I hope you guys are enjoying it again. If you do like the video to show me appreciation, comment as well down. Tell me what you think about this game. Tell me what you think so far. Do you like it? Do you not like it? What would you want to see implemented into this game? If you do also want to get involved with the game, definitely find it on Steam. Even if you don't want to buy it, just look in the forums, you know, suggest anything to the developers, that's also good. But I would suggest that I just get on this kind of, you know, early access train, because I actually genuinely think this is going to be a really good game. As I said, the developers are getting some assistance from SES, who make Euro Truck, and they really want to go in that kind of direction of Euro Truck, the kind of model of Euro Truck, which is a really good model. And we all know how popular Euro Truck is and how good it is, so if this could kind of get to that kind of place where Euro Truck is, it would be so good for the shipping sim genre. So I hope you guys support that if you like ships. Obviously, if you don't, then don't. Stick to trains, stick to trucks, stick to planes, you know. FSX also is coming out on Steam on the 18th of December, which is going to be interesting. I don't know if I'm going to do any kind of content with that. FSX is a bit of a dodgy thing for me, so we'll see. The shoutouts again for this video go to Trainspotter Blake and F.k.w. That's again Trainspotter Blake and F.k.w. Their links and stuff will be down below. Show them some love. If you haven't subscribed and want to subscribe, subscribe to keep up to date with my content. If you have your subscriber module broken, like the Facebook page that I have. It's down below, and that will I post all my uploads. So if you don't get like anything on YouTube showing my uploads on time, then you'll get it on time on Facebook for sure. It's always uploaded. Actually, I always post to Facebook anything I upload straight away after. So Facebook is the most up to date place of what actually happens, like with video wise that happens on my channel. But subscribe anyway on YouTube to keep up to date. If it doesn't work on YouTube's, you know, like the Facebook page, or just like the Facebook page in general, you get cool updates and stuff from that. QWERTYAFRO.co.uk/forums. Get on the forums, get on board, and you know, if you want to join a little community we have, that'd be cool. Anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this European Ship Simulator Mission 2 from Dover to Calais passenger ferry. And I'll see you in the next video, where we'll be looking at the bulk carrier, which is another ship. And we'll be doing that from Calais to Dover. So, hope you guys enjoy it. Have a nice day. I'll see you in another video. Bye-bye. We ain't